Peace and blessings. My name is Leah Penniman, and I am the farm manager and co-director at Soulfire Farm in Grafton, New York. Today, we are going to explain agroforestry and show you how to add value to your agroforestry products by making fruit preserves. Agroforestry consists of farming in the forest and/or farming like the forest. At Soulfire Farm, we have established an agroforestry system that mimics the forest. First, let's look at the Jardin Lacou, Haitian Creole for house garden. This system mimics the forest by having several stories or vertical layers, as well as by having a mixture of species known as a polyculture. It also mimics the forest by sequestering carbon and encouraging biodiversity. Terraces are called fanyaju in Kiswahili, which means throw it upwards. True to the name, this garden was established by moving eroded soil back up the hill and holding it in place with logs from the forest. We planted apple trees on our terraces. Around each tree, we established concentric circles of perennial herbs that have a beneficial relationship with the trees. Some of our favorite companion plants for the orchard are chives, plants in the allium family that attract pollinating insects, discourage burrowing animals, and repel insects. Sage, which grows horizontally to provide a satisfying ground cover, and its aroma wards off pests. Mint and lemon balm. Members of the mint family are powerful insect repellents and contain organic insecticides. Comfrey, which is a dynamic nutrient accumulator. Comfrey has a knack for mining the subsoil for minerals and bringing them to the surface to improve the topsoil. Comfrey can be cut back several times in a season, and its large leaves are used to mulch the trees. We also grow chamomile, echinacea, bee balm, arnica, skullcap, and other medicinal herbs in the understory of the orchard. And we have perennials like jostaberry, juneberry, honeyberry, peach, plum, and hazelnut growing nearby. A layer of wood chips is added to the Jardin Lacou each year to increase organic matter and attract beneficial fungi and other microbes. A cage of hardware cloth is used to protect young trees from rodent damage. We also use a layer of white latex paint to provide protection from cracking during the freeze-thaw cycles of the late winter. Another agroforestry system is known as alley cropping. Here, you can see rows of raspberries interspersed with rows of medicinal herbs like calendula, valerian, St. John's wort, hyssop, blue vervain, mints, tulsi, oregano, and dozens more. We established elderberry along the perimeter of these beds to encourage pollinators and hold the soil in place. Blueberries and strawberries are also suited for alley cropping. We get much of our tree planting guidance from fedcoseeds.com/trees. Now I'm going to show you how to add value to your fruit harvest by making and canning jam or preserves. My earliest memories of growing food are with my grandmother harvesting strawberries and making jam. We are showing you a process for home use. To sell food products, check with your county health department to learn the applicable regulations. We harvest our strawberries, raspberries, and blueberries every 2 days when they are in season. We wash and freeze the berries to keep them until we have enough to make preserves. On jam making day, we weigh the berries and thaw them out. A basic recipe is 2 pounds of fruit, 2 tablespoons of lemon juice, 3 tablespoons low or no sugar pectin, and 1.5 cups of natural sugar. Scale the ingredients to the amount of berries you have. We also need a canning pot with a rack, a canning funnel, and new mason jars with canning lids. For every pound of berries, we need 1 pint of canning space. That means 2 pounds of fruit require a quart-sized canning jar, and so on. First, we sterilize new mason jars and lids by placing them in a pot of water and bringing the water to a simmer. In a separate pot, we mash or blend the berries with the lemon juice and bring the mixture to a boil. We then stir in the sugar. Finally, we add the pectin a little bit at a time and bring the mixture to a full rolling boil once again. Allow the mixture to boil fervently for 1 minute. Skim off any foam that has accumulated on top of the mixture. We remove the sterilized jars from the simmering water and fill them with the berry mixture using the funnel. Fill the jars so they have 1/4 inch space at the top. Place the lids loosely on the jars. Then place the jars on the rack and lower into the water. Bring the water to a full boil and leave the jars in the boiling water for 10 to 12 minutes. Remove the jars, place on a kitchen towel, and let them sit undisturbed for 24 hours. Check to make sure the seal is intact. proper canning preserves food for 1 year. In addition to making preserves, fruit can be dried, frozen, juiced, or even pickled. Integrating perennial fruits and nuts into your landscape is a great way to feed your loved ones and heal the climate. Thank you so much for joining us. We hope you come to love agroforestry as much as we do, wishing you the best in your relationship with trees.